On any given weeknight, Steve Pierre-Jean is here, scribbling away at French homework. He's a high school senior and looking forward to studying international relations next year at Duke. Across town, junior Brittany Williams spends her evenings unwinding with family after a long day at school. Both are prep schoolers, taking advantage of all their private education offers.
Just all the resources they have available to me and like the opportunities that they have.
Opportunities like photography lessons in Paris and prestigious internships. But for Steve and Brittany, aside from the great exposure their schools provide, there's a downside.
I am the minority in my class.
Meaning she walks a delicate line between home life and school life.
Such a kind of shock to go from taking the bus to then having seen kids come up to school and Mercedes-Benz and BMWs.
A shock because they live somewhere very different.
If you think of the student who grows up in the Upper East Side, the difference between home life and school life isn't that great. But for students who didn't grow up in this environment, it's like moving to a different country almost. And in some ways, you have to live two existences.
Columbia University professor Seamus Khan has studied minorities in prep schools for years. He says, aside from the culture shock, academic preparation before prep school can be an issue as well.
Students end up taking more courses at elite prep schools because, and at elite high schools in general, because their overall level of preparation is slightly less.
Former prep schooler Andre Lee created a documentary about his experience.
I felt extremely out of place. I felt like everyone was different from me. No one spoke like me. No one dressed like me. I didn't feel like I fit in at all.
For him and those featured in his film, it's a continual sacrifice for a good education.
In this community, I'm considered real black. In another community, you know, in my neighborhood, I'm considered a white boy. I go to private school.
People always try to say, you're not gangster. You went to prep school. You went to school on Park Avenue. How much harder do you think it is to come back on 142nd Street in Lenox with a polo shirt and penny loafers and survive? That's gangster.
It's two worlds at a high price tag, even though tuition is covered by a scholarship for both Brittany and Steve. Still, their parents say that the practice of balancing two lives can also benefit their children.
That's the African-American experience, meaning that you learn to navigate in multiple worlds in order to seize opportunities.
Opportunities that both Brittany and Steve continue to build their dreams on. Alex Prochet, Rio.com.